I think the battery.
Am I what? It does it back too.
So you're ugly and your mama dressed. I'm surprised they're up here in the afternoon like that.
Hey, you caught it right on top of the water. He's fishing with the bait about 4 or 5 inches underneath the water.
No, I get a meat.
following is a demonstration of how not to swamp. Thank you, thank you. Following this demonstration, also had to threaten your driver with shit if he didn't do it right.
Oh, you want you ski out of here, don't you?
You can't say that.
How quick?
32, I guess.
Got it.
Okay.
Can't see through the screen too well.
Yeah, here's the ice machine right up there.
Uh-huh. I don't have it plugged in on.
Summertime fashion betting like designer water get sheets that starts at $24.95.
Say cheese. I'm just seeing if the camera works. All right, everybody thinks you're a swimmer.
Thank God for Friday.
Thank God for Friday, huh?
Miller Genuine Draft.
Mr. T at home.
On special Miller Genuine Draft Dragnet movie displays wherever beer is sold.
Hello!
Thank God it's Friday!
Offer expires.
Thank God it's Friday.
While supplies last. Miller Genuine Draft. Miller Brewing Company. Milwaukee.
You digging scratch, Ginger. You digging for gold, girl?
Here's the Genesis Women Shelter phone number 942-29. This is the home of that mall, 982.
Ew. Oh, that SVG does. Was it?
Smile for her, sweet pea.
Press his key.
See the moon.
The moon was pulled out of the middle, just on the way to
the Yeah, give us some room. On the dot.
Live. Let's see that six we're talking about here. See, we're gonna have to get music.
that close enough for you?
Up close and personal.
I don't know. O'Neill.
Body by O'Neill.
Miss. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I don't know.
Huh?
I'm about a bum.
Give us your best Tom Cruise there.
Be a ski bum. Lake Leroy. Got a need for speed.
Don't sit on me.
Caretaker for the H2O
Ski
Club.
Down here with Lucky Low. Powder my nose. Lucky, you come down here and ski and all the coke you can get. You don't care what Marcy hears.
My wife knows that, everything.
You want a nose hit before you get out there?
Yeah. I'm going to be loose. Lay down here.
And personal.
Burn,
too late to take.
Is your Tampax binding up on him?
Burn.
Oh, we didn't get that, Dad. Burn.
Have the need to be.
No.
Terrible game, but I'm not gonna wait.
Okay.
Ready to go. Go. Waste rope on those damn long rope pulls. Get in the short line, we'll...
Many days, man.
Okay.
Burn.
Thank you.
bandage.
The red light's blinking.
Yeah.
Hey, hi, ski fans.
This is Bob Saunders.
Wait a second. Hey, ski fans, Bob, how you doing?
Bob Lucky Saunders here.
I can't even hear one.
At beautiful Lake Leroy.
Downtown Bynum, Texas.
Land Baron T.J. D. Rossett. Where's that? Dorset?
The Roach.
Is that De Rossett or?
And this is Jack
Webb. Dorset.
Jack Walker Webb.
Can't find him? Ow!
Thank you.
on Mac. They're taking a bomb apart.
Yeah.
Cut the red and the blue wire.
Huh?
They cut the wires. But first, I looked at each other. Oops.
Let's go water skiing.
yes and not do it. She keeps nodding yes when you tell her to do it. Thank you.
There's the dock potatoes.
Almighty!
We're filming for posterity. We need to move to the other side because the sun is in the lens here. Jesus.
Is that what a real skier looks like, Daddy?
We're in a real boat, boy.
Amaral, Bob and Company.
It needs a bit of slop.
No, I just think we'll just throw him out like he's skiing.
I know it. Let's see how far Travis can swim today. Travis. Let's take him way back into the creek. Let him He has to swim back. There's too much poison ivy on the banks.
26.
20 what?
26.
I thought you were making 30 mile an hour passes now.
It is.
Hit it.
Thank you.
everything else is looking a lot better. Your one's a little easier?
Yeah.
Keep your cut a little bit longer. The one, yeah, even.
Okay.
Try that. The reason you went in at five, you were reaching in front and had your head down. You cut body position all the way around the turn. Just make your cut through the wake and keep that body position. Keep the ski way out in front of you, not rearing back, but keep the same position all throughout the turn. Then when you make the turn, the ski will accelerate. You won't ever even feel anything but acceleration.
What's this right here?
Don't get over the front or anything. Keep this position all the way around the turn. Reach out to the side, pull it in nice and progressively. Go.
Will we burn it? So it would...
before you get to the buoy rather than after you get by it. You see what I'm talking about, Tom? You're getting in a hurry as you finish out the turn. Go ahead and get in a hurry going on into the turn. Your ski will go ahead and go around the buoy. Getting a little more of a rush there and then be a little more patient finishing out. You're doing nice. That was good, nice. You were over to two plenty early and you just kind of got in a hurry finishing out too. Just be patient. Let the ski get in position between you and the boat, okay? Still get your hips up a little further so you won't be having to pull, okay?
Last week we were looking at them.
It looks like I'm still a little open in the shoulders.
Pay attention to that last one. You'll see that your head needs to come up a little. You got your head down.
Yeah.
And you could also lean a little harder after you make your turn at two. Yeah. You had a beautiful two off, but you didn't quite get enough body lean away. It's the only reason you were a little bit late when you got to three. And it's because your left foot forward. And another thing is I didn't used to make people change, and I still don't, but Gordon Ruffin wrote a real strong article in it and explained why you should. In other words, there's about 50% of the open skiers skied, some were wrong and some were right, what they say. But Gordon wrote an article that was really good, and he's a very fine slalom skier. And he explained it as to, I used to wonder what made people do this at the weights. And he explained it like I'm right foot forward, and as I'm going from my 1-3 side, if I've got the wrong hand on top, as I come to the wake, I've got a tendency to go like this because I can't get the shoulder back. See? So it's the easiest thing there is to change is to reverse the handle. And you're left foot forward, and you're skiing with your right hand on top. So you wanna do that when you've got time and just ski some slow passes.
And then,
give me some water, though.
All right, there you go. All right, yeah, I can turn that time off.
I got a jug of water. Use it for fun skiing, family.
Didn't you help with that or something?
lot nicer. Yeah, I don't. You let up going through your gate. You want to go ahead and keep the cutting edge all the way through the weight. But that was much, much better. Yeah. Weight on both feet. Mash down on the ball of that front foot. Make sure you're shoving that ski down in the water. Turning left, then you have to make a real abrupt reach, and you never do even get the handle on it, and then you get the jerk. See what I mean? You don't ever get to finish the turnout, as opposed to reaching toward and then going.
You say enough about the time the boat starts to roll over,
then we start reaching. Okay. In other words, if you reach too quick, you're going to be put in there.
Okay.
It's safer. Think about which is the easiest way to go with the current.
Oh, I'm screaming. Man, I hate skiing. Had a couple of those. Just want to say, shit.
Good body position. You can write a letter to your girlfriend or your wife or think about a poem. You got that much time in the turn. But if we do anything wrong, Jesus, they go by like a picket fence. Bang, bang. You don't have anything on there, do you? Cut early. Anytime you think you got to wait around on number one, you didn't keep your cut long enough. All right? Yeah, you had a nice start. It would have really been a nice one if you'd have just kept the cut through the wakes. You got to keep it through the wakes, some on the other side before you change it. Reach farther. You want to try to reach farther, yeah. You're looking down at the buoy, which is what I think is causing that. Remember to look across the wakes, and then you know you're in position. When you look at the buoy, you know you can make the turn. But if you look at it all the way to it, you're going to turn late. That's what made you turn late at 2, is you just had your eye on the buoy so long. little more. And over there in that two, when you get to number two, get relaxed, keep the ski out in front of you. As the line starts getting shorter, you gotta really mash on that front foot when you start to decelerate in the turns. I don't mean lean over forward. I mean, you gotta really get that ski down in the water, chined in, all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Better to keep the cut too long than not long enough. Good position. Nice body position. Okay. Outside arm.
Huh?
Got your outside arm too far.
Yeah.
I know you got a lot to think about.
I stood up right there and I tried to pull along hard when I did that.
Let's back it off to a little, about 35 and run a 35 and circle and come back at 36.
Well, we're running. He's 34. 30, he's man three.
Oh, he's 34. Okay. A little bit behind. Start.
Want to drive me?
Yep. Go to another buoy or shadow and go back. Don't let the buoy camp knock you down. Practice real good position all the time and don't practice getting in trouble. And then when you get to a tournament, it will make you feel ski the hell out of it. But when you're in practice, just, you know, don't practice.
I shouldn't go for it, I think.
Right, the last two times, when you get in trouble, just give it a shadow a buoy or start on the other side of the porch or something, or just go on out and start all over. Up on the ski, keep that ski shoved hard with your front foot all the way through the weights. First part of the course was nice.
So what was I doing though? What do you say?
You were anticipating and giving up for the weight. Yeah, you were letting your ski fly. Your tip was this high out of the water. It's like you were just letting it up. Shove that sun coming down in the water on that, through the wake. You're working as hard shoving against this tow bar as you are leaning away from it. Especially through the wake. So if you do that, I mean, your slalom will pick up tremendously if you just keep that ski down through the wake. All the way through the wake. Okay. Look like...
What, out of... From two on, he started letting up through the wake.
Yeah, I mean, he got a coming high. He got a good hard pull coming out of two, going to three, and he's good. What'd you do?
I felt the ski bounce. I don't know.
Hey, don't be thinking about too much, but listen. You could reach a little farther out. It'll get your body lean a little lower, a little earlier, and that's what you need. After going into the buoy. That was good. You were in plenty good shape until you got in a hurry with that handle. Okay. All the way through the way. Get your knee flexed a little more in the turns. Out in front of you. Not sit down or anything, but get your knee flexed. Control your reach. Same at every buoy. Just
My dad can't wait right from the back door.
Yeah. That's my bad side. That's my off side.
Okay. Yeah. Lean harder away from the tow bar out of the 245.
Okay.
After you make the turn.
But I think that's not, I don't think that's right.
No, way two, down. He's right not, foot
he's
forward.
He's standing three. Up going to,
really?
It's out of the 1-3, you don't. Yeah, out of the 1-3, you come Bob. Through the wakes like this, and out of the 2-4, you're like this.
Yeah, 2-4 is your good side, Bob.
That's
you're
right
foot forward.
It's out of the 1-3, yeah. You don't keep your lean away from the tow bar on the, okay. On yeah. The,
let's fix the sight. That's bad.
repeat that for film. So I'm really.
Okay, let the ski come on around on the 1-3 a little more before you go. Let the ski complete the turn before you get aggressive against the tow bar, all right? Okay. Position out of three, but he gave up his edge prematurely coming into four.
Why am I getting on the back of my ski all of a sudden? I don't understand.
Because you gave up your cut. You didn't keep your cut like you did out of one and two. Had you kept your cut, you'd have been over there wide. As it was, the boat's in front of you. You're getting pulled in.
Thought that was my best run yet almost.
Right. Exactly. But it only takes one undercut. Progress it, we got problems. Because we're running at an astronomical, and that, how would he say it? We're just running at a high rate of speed when we go to the next buoy with the towboat.
Okay. That was built a lot better there to me. I guess I was ahead more than I usually am. But I guess
going into 2-4 side, you've got a moment where you like to ride a flat ski. You better not be doing that.
Going into the buoy?
After you make your head change at 2 and going to 2-4. Ride a flat ski momentarily.
Okay. On the 2 side, going from 2-3.
Pardon? Going from, going into 2-4.
Okay.
Keep your cut through the wake all the time, and then look at the buoy and you'll turn.
Let me get my ski back on here. Let's go to sleep here.
get a little softer, the ski will slow down more and you won't be going in the water like that. That was nice.
That one felt kind of like maybe I might have been doing something right.
Number four was like, seems like that's a habit around here, that outside hand got back.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the only time you did it.
Well, I'll think about it for a minute.
God, okay.
You got five and a half. You almost got one.
One time also.
Do you shadow the hoods a lot? Not run the hoods a
try
lot?
Try to.
Good. I mean, just not even thinking about the hoods a lot of times. Ski technique.
26.
Same as a map.
Relax!
Across the course and through the wakes. Okay. Let me show you kind of what you're doing. You're getting out there and you're whipping and then you're going through the wakes and then you're taking it again. Okay. And slalom, we can only do it once.
Right.
So just make a nice gradual turn and keep your position all the way through both wakes and then some. And then number two will be right there for you to turn at. Okay.
I have a two stage.
Yeah. Just let's just do it. okay? And then after you make the turn at two, when you're coming across out of two, you're trying to pull with your arms, see, and that's making you stand straight up.
Right.
So just lean with your body. Look across where you're going to number three, and just lean with your body, okay? That was good out of one. You just whipped one just a little too hard right at first. I thought you were going to do it again. Hey, that was all right. Hey. Little. Did y'all hear what she said? Little?
Yeah, when Buddy hollered about you, you
can
hear him up there on the dial.
I tried not to interfere with your performance, but that was much better. See, did you see what I was doing while I go?
Uh-huh.
When you pull,
yeah.
You're one of the people. So you get off your edge.
That's what I've been doing.
Yeah. Good girl. Yeah, you can run that. That's fast, easy.
Sometimes I can, sometimes I don't.
You'll get it. See, and that was with a late start out of one, Terry.
Because I tried to be smaller.
Yeah, easier. But I mean, you started way down course. If you'd have started early, you could have probably ran all six, so that's